In this short video, I would like to show you the three typical ways to carry around your diving mainline so your rig remains constantly streamlined and you avoid any risk of entanglement before, during, and after the dive. The way we're gonna use or stow our main light highly depends on our intentions, of course. So let's start with the permanent position when our light is off. When we, for example, prepare for the dive, we go into the water or we go out when the dive is finished. Then we just want to have our light switched off and stowed neatly, not to disturb us and interrupt with any other piece of our equipment. And to do so, we use this bolt stop, which is permanently attached to the light, to clip it off to the right chest D-ring. And we can stow the cable under our long hose, if we use the configuration with the long hose, of course, and under the waist strap of our harness. In that way, it remains constantly really close to the body, neatly stowed and secured from any risk of entanglement. The second point is our time for exploration. And most of the time during the dive, the light will remain in our hand. Preferably on the Goodman handle, like we have here. A really handy feature about the adjustable Goodman handle is that we can actually adjust it in the way that it fits to the size of our hand and to the size of our gloves that we are using at that particular dive. So if I need to do something with both my hands, like writing in my wet notes, for example, I still keep full control over the light and communication with my team. The third position of our main light is somewhere in between the first two. Talking about the temporary clip-off now. So here I will use an additional double ender and an eyelet located somewhere on the cable just behind the head of our light. And here I will clip it to the eyelet, I mean the double ender to the eyelet, and the other side I'll clip it off again to my D-ring, my chest D-ring. And the difference is that in that way the light will be directed down. So in that way, if I need to use my both hands and at the same time I would like to stay in front with my eye contact with my team, I will not flash them into their eyes, just have the light under control, pointing down, and if needed, I can still very efficiently move it and communicate with all the range of motions that I need. Yeah, so that's it for today. Thank you very much for watching. I hope those tips will help you improving and making your configuration with your light more streamlined and safe and therefore enjoyable underwater. Yeah, safe dives and hope to see you back soon here in the Tecline Academy. Have fun.